In this closer look, you'll be doing some scientific notation practice. Scientific notation allows you to express numbers using powers of 10, such as 2.5 times 10 to the third. In standard notation, that same number is written as 2,500. Here's a chart that shows how scientific notation and standard notation compare. See how the pattern works? When converting from scientific notation to standard notation, use the exponent as a guide, which will tell you how many places to move the decimal. In the first example, you have 9.9 times 10 to the third power. To convert that to standard notation, when there is a positive exponent, like this one, you move the decimal here, to the right. And since there is a value of 3 from the positive exponent, the decimal will move to the right 3 places. So take the decimal and move it 1, 2, 3 places, like this, and this will be the new place for the decimal. And then fill in these other spots with zeros. So 9.9 times 10 to the third power is the same thing as 9,900. The second example is 7.22 times 10 to the first power. If there is a positive exponent, remember, move the decimal to the right, and in this case, only move it one place to the right, so it would be 72.2. Now let's look at 1.14 times 10 to the minus first power. A negative exponent means that the decimal value moves to the left when you convert it to standard notation. There is a negative 1, so slide that decimal to the left one place. And the new value is 0.114. Let's look at 1.01 times 10 to the minus second power. To convert it to scientific notation, move the decimal two places to the left, like this. And here's the new decimal point. Again, fill in any gaps with zeros. So the standard notation for this number is 0.0101. Let's do another one. Let's take 8.78 times 10 to the minus third power. Since the exponent is negative, slide this decimal to the left 1, 2, 3 places, and there's the new decimal value. Fill in these gaps with zeros, and you now have 0.00878. Now let's practice a few going the other way, from standard notation to scientific notation. And remember, if you're going to convert to scientific notation, move the decimal as many places as necessary to have one non-zero integer, so 1 to 9, to the left of the decimal place. In 1,100,000, there's an understood decimal at this spot here. So to convert this to scientific notation, move that decimal all the way over until there is one non-zero integer to the left of the decimal. Let's see how many places you need to move it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 6 places that you had to move the decimal. To write this in scientific notation, write what you're left with, which is 1.1 times 10 to the 6th power. The next example of converting from standard notation to scientific notation is 2,100. And again, there's an understood decimal here. So move that decimal 1, 2, 3 places. Now you have 2.1. And since this represents a large number, 2,100, move the decimal to the left 3 places, which represents the exponent. So you have 2.1 times 10 to the third. Now let's look at 0.021. You're going to need to move the decimal to the right because, again, the rule is to move the decimal until you get to the spot where there's one non-zero integer to the left. After moving the decimal, you have 2.1. It's in scientific notation, but it's representing a number smaller than 1, so 2.1 times 10, and in this case, you put a negative exponent, so it will be negative 2. So you have 2.1 times 10 to the minus second power, and that is 0.021 in scientific notation. Let's try this, 0.00019. To represent this number in scientific notation, move the decimal 1, two, three, four places so that the decimal is behind the one. So it will be 1.9 times 10 to the minus fourth power. This is representing a number smaller than one, so the exponent will be negative. The last example is 23 million. So when you start off with 23 million, there's an understood decimal here. Move it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 places. So that will be 2.3. The decimal moved 7 places, and this is representing a large value. So once we convert it to scientific notation, it will have a positive exponent. Remember, anytime you have a positive exponent in scientific notation, you are representing a value larger than 1. And anytime you have a scientific notation value that has a negative exponent, that represents a number smaller than 1. Now we're going to let you practice a few on your own. So pause the video and try the following problems. Then come back, press play, and check your answers. 749.3, 7.493 times 10 to the second. 0.0000799, 7.99 times 10 to the minus fifth power. So hopefully for the first problem, you moved the decimal until it was right after the 7. Since the decimal was moved 2 places, and since this number in scientific notation represents a number larger than 1, the exponent would be a positive 2. In the second problem, you had a number smaller than 1 to convert to scientific notation. So once it's converted, it should have a negative exponent. The decimal moves 5 places, and the answer is 7.99 times 10 to the minus fifth power. That's a closer look at scientific notation. For more chemistry matters, go to our homepage where the entire series is available to you.